Hey friends, welcome to another Photoshop tutorial. So in this tutorial I'm going to cover the basics of Photoshop, and I'm going to simply explaining these tools and give you the basic idea what you can do with all these tools. So let's get started. So first of all, when you open a Photoshop, while taking a new page, you will get something like this. The default setting of the Photoshop is like this. On the top left corner you could see this arrow. If you click once, all the tools will be arranged in this form, single column, and if you again click it, all will be in the default two column. So I will be going forward with this setting also. Now the first is the move tool. Before going to that, you can see this small arrows on the corner. This means that it also has a hidden menu, hidden tools within it. Simply right click on these tools to access the rest of the options. So first one is the move tool, which allows you to move the objects. For example, if I draw a simple square like this and I want to move this around on the page, so simply click on this move tool and you could easily click and hold and drag the mouse to move it around. So this is simply a move tool. Now the next is the marquee tools. The first one is the, if you right click on it, the options pops out, which will give you rest options. The first one is the rectangular marquee tool, which allows you to create this type of rectangle shapes on the page. Simply drag the mouse to create a rectangle like this. If you hold the shift key, it will create a perfect square like this. And if you want to fill the color in it, press alt and backspace and this foreground color will be filled in it, as you can see. And again, if you go to this elliptical marquee tool, which will allow you to create a circle like this. So as you can see, while holding the shift key, if you drag your mouse, it will create a perfect circle. And if you do not hold the shift key, simply drag the mouse, it will create a circle like this. And the rest is the single lines column. So now let's jump to next options in it. So let me just delete this layer and take a new layer. And now the next is the lasso tool, which help you to make the selection. So I am taking this simple image and this is the lasso tool. If I want to cut this with free hand, you could simply use this lasso tool to make the selection. And you can simply press Ctrl X to cut it and like this, or you could use in various ways this selection tool. This is the polygonal lasso tool, which allows you to make the selection in the straight lines like this, as you can see. And if you and this is the magnetic lasso tool, which also used to make the selections. And now moving on to the next is the quick selection tool. By For example, taking this image, if I want to make the selection of it, by selecting the quick selection tool, simply you have to drag your mouse and the quick selection tool, all the same color will be automatically selected like this. Now you could simply press Ctrl X and now Ctrl V, and now you have cut this out, as you can see. So with the quick selection tool, it's easy to make the selection if the colors are of same colors are there. Magic wand tool is also for making the selection. It makes the selection of the same color all at once. For example, if I click here once, as you can see, all this black portion has been selected. If I click once here, all the same colors will be selected like this. So these are simply the tools to make the selection. So moving to next tool is the crop tool. So if you want to increase or even decrease the size of the page, you could use the crop. Simply click on the crop tool and move your mouse here and decrease the size. So as you can see, the page size of the page has been reduced. You can not only reduce, even you could increase the size. Simply drag up and, as you can see, press enter to confirm it. So now this is the page size. So moving on to the next is the eyedropper tool, which simply allows you to make the pick the color from the image. So have a look at this. Currently it's in the red. Now if I click the mouse and move this mouse cursor here and there, it will pick the color, same color. As you can see, I am currently placing out a green. It's the foreground is color is the green color. So simply if you want to pick any color, you could use this eyedropper tool. Now this is the spot healing brush tool, pass tool, and these all are used to simply create, or if you want to remove anything from an image, then these are really helpful. For example, if I'm using the spot healing brush tool while selecting this, if I want to simply erase this portion, I'm going to select this portion, and as you can see, it's disappeared. If I want to simply disappear this, I'm going to simply make this selection, and now as you can see, it will disappear. As you can see, so this is simply used to make the spot healing, and the other are also the similar thing. Healing brush tool, patch tool allows you to simply make a selection from anywhere, as you can see, and now drag it. Now this portion will be replaced on this, as you can see. So this is the patch tool, and the next is the content aware and the red eye tool. If you are moving on to the next more useful tool, which is the brush tool, if you select the brush tool and right click, you would access the default brushes available on the Photoshop. If you want to load your own brush, simply click this gear icon and click here to load the brushes. You could see there are lots of preloaded brushes given to you. If I click on this natural brushes and press OK to add it or append to again continue adding here. So I am pressing the OK. So these are the some brushes here. You could press the while bracket keys to increase or decrease the size of the brush. So this is the brush tool. There are lots of brushes, as you can see. So this is the simple brush. If you right click, you could adjust the size and the hardness of the brush and increase or decrease the size. Now moving on to the next is the pencil tool, which is again you could easily create anything. And the next is the clone tool. So if you want to make a clone of something, for example this clock, then what you can do is simply press Alt key here and press click once. And now if you want to create the clock here, as you can see, this clock will appear here. So this is used to make the cloning of anything if you want. Not only that, if you want to disappear this clock, press Alt and click once, and now you could fill the color besides this clock to make look that this clock has been disappeared. So this is just I am showing the example. I am not showing you how to do that, what these tools can do. So now moving to the next tool is the eraser tool. This is simple eraser tool. You could simply click here and start erasing. And now if you right click on it, is the magic eraser tool, which erases the same color all at once. So as you can see, this is the same wavelength color of green. If I click once, it will delete all this all at once. As you can see, this is the whole white color. If I again click on it, it has deleted it. So it will erase all the same color all at once with this magic eraser tool. So this is really useful tool. Now this is simple, the gradient tool. So for example, I'm making a selection and I'm going to fill a gradient in it. So simply drag the mouse and it will fill the gradient. So this is the gradient tool. So now I'm moving to next on the is the blur tool. So this blur tool sharpen and the is used to make the any portion blur. For example, I am going to blur this. Simply hold the click the mouse and start applying the blur, and as you can see, this has been blurred and this is focused. Similarly, you can sharpen any area if you want, increase or decrease the size with the bracket keys, and you could simply click and to make the sharp. So as you can see, this area has been sharpened than this, as this is the blurred area. Now the next tool is the dolls tool. If you want to add the extra lighting to any particular area of the photo, simply use this tool, and as you can see, the lights are being added. Similarly, this is to make the area more darker. And the next is the paint tool, which is again used to create more complex shapes, or you could make the complex selections with the use of this paint tool. And this is the freehand paint tool. Now if you want to add a text, then this is the text tool. Simply click once. So let me take a simply new page. So simply click once, and from here you could adjust the size, drag here, and I'm just typing anything, and from here you could easily change the font, make the selection here, press Ctrl A to make whole selection. Now use the arrow keys to simply change the fonts. You could access the all the font setting on the top. As you can see, you could also change the color from here. And this is the most useful tool is the shape tool. So they are also predefined custom shape tool. If you click on it, you will get a new icon here, shape. Simply click on this lower icon. Initially you will not get this tab. When you open the first time, you will only get a few shapes in it. And if you want to add more shapes in it, you could click here. As you can see, animals, fill. So they are just shapes. So for example, if I'm going to click on the nature and click OK, and this is the butterfly, double click on it to select it, press shift and alt key and drag the mouse to create this shape. Now this is the path. If you want to make it to the selection, press Ctrl and enter to make it selection. Now you could fill in the color in it, any color you want, as you can see. So this is really useful tool. And this is simply the zoom tool. Select the zoom tool and click once to zoom in. There are various ways to zoom. You could also press simply Alt and use the cursor on your mouse to zoom in, zoom out, or you could also press Ctrl and plus or minus key to zoom in or zoom out. So these were some of the basics I had explained it in this Photoshop tutorial. If you want more tutorials like this, do comment below. So that's all in this video, friend. I'll see you in the next video.
If you enjoyed this video, friends, drop a like, leave a comment if you have any questions to ask, and subscribe to this channel now as more exciting videos coming up. And do share this video with your friends and family. This is Shubham signing off.